this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you some amazing track mat tricks. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. And let's start with some basics. So what are track mats and how are they different from masks? Masks cut out parts of a layer. Let's decrease the shape size a little bit. And up here, you can switch to Tool Creates Mask. Now you create a mask and cut out parts of the shapes we just created. By default, the mode is set to add. You can subtract the mask. Let's quickly create an overlapping second one. You can intersect them and so on. Lots of possibilities. The problem is, once you move the layer, the masks move along. And we don't always want that. That's why track mats are really useful. With track mats, you can determine the visibility of another layer. And since After Effects 23, you can use one track mat for as many layers as you want. Let's check it out. I just used the title tool to add some text. Fill color, white, no stroke. Let's quickly center the layer with the align tool. Then, with no layer selected, let's add a new rectangular shape by double-clicking on the rectangle tool. Fill color white as well, and rename it, of course, track mat. Then you probably have to click this button down here to see the track mat column, or click down here to expand the panel. Then you either choose your track mat layer from the drop-down menu or link it with the track mat pick whip. The layer turned into a track mat, indicated by this symbol, and it is hidden. Now you've got two separate layers you can animate independently from each other. Let's move the track mat down and you can see only the white area is visible. So you could animate the mat and reveal the text. Or you could invert the track mat by clicking this right box here and animate the text layer to reveal the text. The alpha track mat works with the alpha information of a layer to determine the transparency. In the info window up here, you can see the RGBA values. A255 means transparent or visible. A0 means invisible. I prefer to use the Luma track mat. It uses the luminance or brightness channel of a layer. Let's disable the inversion of the mat. Then let's add a gradient ramp to the shape layer using the effects and presets window. Here it is. Let's add it to the layer. Let's make the layer visible again and adjust the start and end of ramp. Let's hide the layer again, and to turn it into a Luma track mat, click on the left box again. Black means 0% opacity, white means 100% opacity. And if you animate the gradient, you can create a soft reveal of your text. Have you ever used expressions in After Effects? They are incredibly helpful. Like this particles rig. Once set up, you can use it again and again. Impossible with keyframes. Or create a transition rig, for example. Use expression controls to quickly adjust it. Then use this template in Premiere Pro. I know this is overwhelming at the beginning. That's why in my new course, we start from zero. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. Plus, I add new bonus content every month. You will create animations that wouldn't be possible without expressions. Join now and learn how to animate with expressions and After Effects. All right, let's add the background. With no layer selected, let's double click on the rectangle tool and add another shape layer. We name it background. And let's use a linear gradient fill this time. We choose two colors, a dark pink and a slightly brighter pink. Let's adjust the start and end of ramp. We move it down in the layer stacking order and choose the track mat layer as well. Turn it into a Luma mat, and this time we invert the mat. So you can use one track mat for as many layers as you want. The text is transparent towards the left, the background towards the right. And the track mat layer can be anywhere in the layer stacking order. Awesome. Now that you know the basics, let's up our game a little bit. We delete the track mat layer and quickly animate the text layer with two position keyframes. Let's move it from the bottom left corner to the top right corner. We quickly open the graph editor and adjust the speed curve. Awesome. Then we add an echo effect to the text layer. Set echo time to -0.005. Number of echoes to 85. Decay 0.95. Then we use it as inverted Luma track mat for the background layer, which cuts out the text. Then we add some footage. Awesome. I think we should add more details. Venetian blinds, maybe. We use the effects and presets window again. And set the transition completion to 15%. Direction 45 degrees, which creates vertical lines. You can also make the track mat layer visible again. And change the blending mode to, let's say, soft light. Here's the difference. Very useful for compositing. Finally, let's quickly duplicate the text layer. And let's use a stroke instead of a fill. We set the blending mode back to normal and disable the effects. Awesome. One more thing. I created two simple shapes, a circle and a square. Let's use the circle as alpha track mat for the square, which creates this half circle. Let's invert it, the square minus the circle shape. Then let's use the square as alpha track mat for the circle. Make both layers visible again, the square and the half circle. Let's invert the upper track mat as well. The middle part is cut out. Let's duplicate the circle and change the fill color and disable the inversion. The new shape fills the cutout part. The track mat system is incredibly flexible and allows you to create amazing stuff. Animating abstract shapes, for example. Create stuff that isn't even possible with keyframes with my expressions course. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.